place, whatever it's called. Come get your stuff.
Okay.
I got like two backpacks. I went over there and I stuffed both of them full. Them shits were heavy. And I put them in the back of my car, in the trunk of my Honda. And it still wasn't enough. And so I unloaded the rest of the batteries in the back of my trunk too. And we fucking, the next day I brought them in my shop. So the reason why it was cool in Sweden though, because they didn't fucking have batteries, so they couldn't do any operations. They couldn't, radio operators didn't really get to do any of the actual operations. And it wasn't like Ukraine where we couldn't use our cell phones. They're in fucking Sweden. They could use their cell phones. They weren't supposed to, but they could. Ukraine, I wasn't allowed to do shit. I had my phone off the whole time except for like the last week where I kept that bitch on airplane mode. Everything I fucking setting I had to turn on me off service, I disconnected everything. I took videos. I took like two videos, but they're not very interesting. One of them is of a dude, Nick, getting, he was holding our shit because the day after we got soaked, he's holding this fucking rivet and somebody's spraying the fuck out of him. And he brings it over his head and starts fucking screaming. I don't remember what the other one is. I think it's just people climbing in a tree. What did happen when I was in Haiti is I fucking slammed my head against the goddamn wall. Because it was late at night, and I had to go count radios. It was like fucking 3 a.m., and I was tired. And I go and count the radios, and I'm walking back, and it's fucking dark as shit. Because they have the night lights on, which are just like orange lights in the hallways. And I'm walking, and I'm already tired as shit. I'm already kind of falling everywhere because I'm tired. And the ship rocks fast as shit. Like, damn near feels like it turns over. And I lost my balance and I fucking face planted into the side of the wall where, like, piping was. And I fucking sat there for, like, a solid, like, 10 minutes. And I was like, I should just go to sleep on the ground. I don't need to go back to my bunk. And I was like, somebody's gonna be like, oh, fuck, where'd Madison go? And this Navy guy, who I guess was on some type of guard duty, walked by and he's like, are you okay? Yeah, I hit my head. You need medical? No. He's like, you need anything? You need to go to sleep, dude. He's like, you shouldn't, and he's all being the fucking Navy corpsman or whatever. He's like, you shouldn't go to sleep. He's like, you might have a concussion if you hit your head that hard. And I was like, I'm going to sleep. I got up and I washed my barracks, my bunking area. Galley. On the bright side, Reyes also went to Haiti, but he also didn't do anything. They brought, I shit you not, the only people that came with us were like a platoon of infantry guys, which is about, let's see, like 20 people, or 20 infantry guys, two officers, a staff NCO, and then our radio corps, which was me and my sergeant and my staff sergeant, because Reyes was included with the platoon. Oh, and another sergeant, because Reyes didn't do shit because one of our H&S sergeants went with him to do actual radio shit instead of Reyes, because he was new to the company. So Reyes also didn't do anything, but he wasn't. I didn't get to sleep with Reyes. I don't even know where he was half the time. I think I saw him once in the chow hall. He looked depressed.
I mean, there's nothing to be happy about.
I mean, he didn't do anything for me. He told me that he did the same exact shit I did, which, except he didn't even go to the gym. He just fucking sat there. Probably fucking jerked off on his phone like everybody else did. God, that is one thing that I do not miss about being on a ship. Holy fuck. You get off of fucking radio watch or doing whatever the fuck you have to do in the middle of the night, and you go in there, and all you smell is cum. And all you hear is fucking... And some motherfuckers don't have headphones, so you can actively hear whatever porn they're watching. Like, do you not have any fucking, like, self-respect? Fucking smoke. Now, granted, some of the grossest shit I've ever seen was when I accidentally walked into the Navy side, where, like, they sleep and stuff. It was so fucking dirty. They have no discipline. There was fucking trash bags on the ground. There was people's shit just kind of on the ground. Stuff thrown around because they were too lazy to, like, pack it up after whatever they were doing. It smelled bad. None of them wanted to do their fucking laundry. I don't know what. Half the Navy guys are fat. And I mean, like, actually fat. Not, like, military standard fat. And so they take up the whole fucking, like, ships are very small. I don't know if you've ever seen the inside of a ship. It's small. And I have to work my way around this dude that takes up, like, 90% of the fucking hallway. Ugh. And they always smell bad. Living memories that I tried to suppress. Like these elf clothes. That's what they're like. All fucking dirty and stinky. You know what this is?
Stinky. Well, see, SpongeBob, that's your problem. You have it set to M for Minnie, when it should be set to W for Wombo.
Patrick, what the fuck is Wombo?
You know Wombo. He Wombo. She Wombo. He, she, the Wombo. Wombo. Wombology. God, I hate these ones that are just like
a bunch of little shit.
It's like a literal
shit that has sides.
It's like a speck. I'm just like scanning for a speck.
In a fucking way, you want me to climb inside Santa's suit to get some of this fucking shit out? Fuck, I still have those beans out. I need to package them. have my half gallon of beans.
Beans.
I probably shouldn't package them, because I know I'm not going to eat them.
Hey, bro.
I wonder how much water we've used.
Probably enough to give to a whole country. What? It's so stupid. Santa better be giving me some head after this.
Fuck no, you get a couple pop dollars.
Yeah, some of these have like exactly like one little thing left and it pisses me off.
Dude, have you seen the fucking grotto floor itself? Got it. Holy fucking shit. I'm fucking screen capping that shit. There was a little speck. Come here, look at this shit. There was a little piece of the floor right here. That was for the whole wooden floor.
Jesus Christ. Thank fucking God. Where the fuck am I supposed to find these? What? Finally, fuck.
I have to clean behind these little posters. Dude, this isn't even possible. What the fuck?
What? Up this again, come on. Thank you.
Fuck, man.
And what else am I supposed to do? Oh, wait, the top. Bada bing, bada boom. Thank you. Why is there so much? God damn, I hate these stupid fucking... Something is 94%. Huh? Entrance door hinges. Yo, what are you doing, step ladder?
Has to be a glitch.
Damn, 99 everything, almost. What? What? Come on, bro. Santa office door handle. That's... Thank fucking God. What are these stupid ass?
Fuck is Grotto skirting?
Man, how is this fair? Nutcrackers.
What the fuck is it?
Where the fuck is this stupid dot?
My Aristotle just... This is the last thing on the list. Just fucking clean the wall.
I can't find it. Look how close it is.
You know where it is?
No.
Come here. Stand right here and look between the wall and this. Do you see it?
That's bullshit.
I was trying to go at it for like a solid 20 minutes. I don't know how to do it. Like... Like, that's the only yellow I see on the wall. Fuck! I finally got it. Holy shit. It was like the little trimming right here. Fuck, man.
How long is that? That was like hours.
Fucking timestamp. The quick time event. Whatever it's called. Let me see the time it took.